Hello everyone, this is Ravens from Digi Integrative. Welcome to Tech News episode 255. With Oppo Syno Day 2021 coming up on December 14th, we are bound to see some exciting new technology. Last year, we saw the brand's rollable concept smartphone, and this year, Oppo is teasing a self-developed retractable rear camera module. OnePlus has announced that it will be attending CES 2022 in Las Vegas, scheduled between January 3rd and January 8th. However, the event organizers will run its CES 2022 digital venue program until January 31st, 2022. OnePlus will be at CES 2022 on January 5th, starting at 6:30 p.m. PST, and OnePlus event will last for 3 hours, possibly allowing it time to reveal the OnePlus 10 series, and the OnePlus 10 Pro is expected to feature the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 processor along with 4 rear-facing cameras, and this device should be having a 6.7-inch display too, within which OnePlus has included a punch hole for a single front-facing camera. OnePlus Buds Z2 is tipped to launch in India this month. It may launch in obsidian black and pearl white colors. OnePlus Buds Z2 could be priced under Rs. 6,000. Realme RMX 3310 has today received a TINA certification, which has revealed the first look and key specifications. Judging by the images and the specifications, the Realme RMX 3310 appears to be a GT series phone. The new Realme GT phone might launch in Q1 of 2022. Moto Edge X30 Special Edition with an under-display camera has been confirmed officially. The new edition will debut in China on December 9th. The Moto Edge X30 Special Edition will ship with the Qualcomm Snapdragon 8 series chipset, probably the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 processor. TCL introduced a prototype smartphone called as Fold and Roll back in April 2021, which as the name suggests folds and slides. It has a display that begins on the cover, curves around the side, unfolds and continues all the way to the right hand side, then it expands to the left, turning into a 10-inch tablet. And we thought that the project might never see the light of day and will remain within all the realms of digital design, but a short video from DTC 2021, China revealed there is one unit in the real life. Qualcomm announced that its flagship Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 processor is manufactured in Samsung's 4-nanometer foundries, but some production issues are forcing Qualcomm to shift a part of the production to TSMC. Qualcomm introduced a Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 flagship processor for Android devices last week, and with that began the race among smartphone brands to become the first company to launch the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 powered smartphone. Xiaomi founder and CEO mentioned that Xiaomi 12 series will be the world's first smartphone to have the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 processor under the hood, but the Motorola beat it by announcing its December 9 event to introduce the Moto Edge X30 powered by the Qualcomm latest silicon. Soon after, Realme VP also confirmed the December launch of Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 powered GT 2 Pro, and today the young brand took to Weibo to announce on December 9th announcement for the Realme GT 2 Pro. Samsung Electronics Corporation Limited will merge its mobile and consumer electronic divisions. The firm said on Tuesday, naming new co-chief executive in the biggest reshuffle since 2017 to simplify its structure and focus on the logical chip business. Vivo has filed a trademark application under the Class 12 category. The class includes various vehicle types such as electric cars, motorcycles, and driverless cars. Vivo could start as an electric vehicle journey in India with an electric scooter or motorcycle. Xiaomi is currently testing an upgraded 100-watt fast charging technology for large battery capacities that will not only boost charging time significantly, but will also seriously consider battery longevity. HP Omen 16 laptop comes with an NVIDIA RTX 3070 GPU with an 8GB of video memory. This laptop is rated to deliver a battery life up to 9 hours. HP Omen 16 features a 16.1-inch display with a 3-millisecond response time and a 100% of sRGB color gamut. The HP Omen 16 laptop price in India starts at ₹1,39,999. Last November, WhatsApp introduced a disappearing message feature that deletes chats automatically after 7 days. And a year later, it has increased the time limit, allowing you to set messages for auto-deletions after 24 hours or 90 days in addition to the previous 1-week option. Not just that, WhatsApp users will now also have an option to turn on the disappearing messages feature for all new individual chats by default. Previously, it had to be enabled manually, and once you have turned on the default disappearing message, this app will display all messages in your chat, telling the same to the people so they know that it is nothing personal. Uttar Pradesh government led by Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath has announced that the state government will be distributing smartphones and tablets for free among youth of the state under UP Smartphone Tablet Distribution Scheme. The Yogi government has a plan to provide free smartphones and tablets to the youth from the second week of December 2021. PUBG New State is getting a new update later this week. The upcoming PUBG New State update brings a new vehicle, survivor pass weapon and a weapon customization options. PUBG New State is expected to get a Christmas themed event soon. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.